Hello, dear Steemians, Dtubers, members of Uptrend, and all beautiful and creative blockchain people. That's me again at CryptoSpine. This is my next cryptocurrency market overview. So let's start. Let's have a look at the price of the major cryptocurrencies according to the beautiful site of CoinGecko. And we see that most of the major cryptocurrencies, actually their prices have been slightly declining. And for example, Bitcoin has recorded a price decrease by 2.5% for the last 24 hours. Almost the same price dynamic or almost the same price decline has been recorded by Ethereum, XRP, Bitcoin Cash, Litecoin, EOS, etc. So we know that a few days ago or last week, a solid price increase took place. Then it was followed by slight consolidation. And now it seems that the price is slightly declining. But I just want to mention that I will comment on the price chart of Bitcoin next Monday. So usually on Mondays, I analyze the price chart of Bitcoin. On Tuesdays, I analyze the price chart of Steam. Yesterday was Wednesday, so I analyzed the price chart of Ethereum. That's why usually in the first part of the week I comment on the price chart of the major cryptocurrencies. Today I want to comment or to outline some interesting crypto-related news. And the first thing is that, for example, according to news.bitcoin.com, Reserve Bank of India confirms crypto is not banned in India. So they try to clarify the issue with the cryptocurrencies, because I remember a week or 2 weeks ago in the news I saw many articles claiming that Reserve Bank or the Central Bank of India is going to ban crypto in the country. It turned out to be some misunderstanding according to this article, and I saw this article or familiar articles in other media outlets. So I want to say that I'm happy when I see that certain countries, their institutions, they support the development of the new technologies such as blockchain, including, I mean, crypto and etc. So this is very beneficial for all the people all over the world. And that's why I want to mention some other positive news relating to implementation of new technologies in the world. Another good example is Uzbekistan. It's a big country actually in Central Asia. And according to this article, and I saw such kind of titles in many other media outlets, Uzbekistan prepares crypto tax exemptions, launches license exchange. So here is a kind of a snapshot of part of those documents or regulations or actually decree issued by the head of state in the summer that regulates, let's say, cryptocurrencies and blockchain, or set out the framework for their operations. And I'm really very happy when I see crypto-friendly, let's say, countries or nations, because in this way they support the development of new technologies. And I just want to point out that some very interesting points here in this article, that for example, the government in Tashkent, this is the capital of Uzbekistan, also intends to create a regulatory sandbox for testing crypto technologies called Uzbekistan Blockchain Wallet. Also, they have launched their crypto license exchange Uznex. Uzbekistan's new digital asset trading platform is operated by the Korean company Kobea Group. Its launch was announced Monday, January 20, during an operation ceremony in Tashkent, where the Korean Cultural Center hosted an international blockchain conference. So this is a picture of the launch of this crypto exchange. And that crypto exchange will be open to international citizens or users as well, not only to people, the residents of Uzbekistan. At the moment, this platform, the license platform that was launched, is now online and offers several trading pairs, again, Bitcoin Core and the stablecoin Tether. This includes Bitcoin Cash, Ethereum. Also, you can use the Uzbekistan's national currency and US dollars and credit cards. So I'm really very happy about such kind of developments. And I decided to have a look at this exchange Uznex that is regulated, that is licensed, and that was launched recently a few days ago in Uzbekistan. And this is actually their site. And when I opened the site of this exchange, the Uzbekistan cryptocurrency exchange, I saw the logo of Murgo and Cardano. And this is Kobea, the Korean company or group operating the exchange. And then it came to my mind that recently I saw another articles that Cardano, and we know Cardano is one of the biggest, let's say, cryptocurrency ecosystems, is top 10. And it came to my mind that I saw in media outlets news that Cardano and developers from the Cardano ecosystem announced some kind of partnerships with either the government of Uzbekistan to support the development and implementation of the blockchain technology in the country. And I researched it, so I used pre-search to find this information. And this is actually Cardano and Emurgo. Emurgo is, let's say, one of the instruments or one of the sub-communities in Cardano developing applications like software wallets and etc. for Cardano. And this is the site of Emurgo. Emurgo is drives the adoption of Cardano and adds value to ADA holders. Emurgo building a global Cardano. And when I researched it, many articles popped up immediately like this one. Emurgo establishes blockchain task force with Uzbekistan. Emurgo, the official commercial and venture arm of the Cardano blockchain project, is setting up a blockchain task force in partnership with the government of Uzbekistan. And I'm really very happy once again that those are proactive, pro-crypto active governments that try to attract brains from all over the world to help develop their infrastructure. I mean the infrastructure for new technologies. So thumbs up really for this country in Central Asia. And the last thing I want to mention about this is I'm really very happy when I saw the logo of Emurgo, because back in September of 2019, so let's say half a year ago, I had the pleasure to interview the CTO of Emurgo, Nicolas Arqueros. So he's the CTO of Emurgo. I met him in the city of Plovdiv during the Cardano second anniversary, and I had an interview with him. I asked him about Emurgo, about what the main idea of Emurgo is, how do they see the further development of Cardano, and etc. So I'm really very happy about it. And actually, that's it for today, fellas. Thank you for watching. Let's hope that many other places or jurisdictions will support the implementation and development of development and implementation of new technologies. Of course, I wish you a wonderful day and hope to see you in the next video. It was me at CryptoSpot.